I know nobody's probably gonna see this for a while, so what's up? We're gonna start a new one. We use current rosters. Let's model me after somebody. Let's go J up. No. Let's go with the big man, Miguel. Play for the Central, obviously. Go Zach. I thought that, for number, gotta go number 7, Pudge Rodriguez. I don't want to be a first baseman. What? Oh. Okay. We'll create a custom player. We're gonna be. Let's put me at the hot corner. Let's just go right. Again. For the second time. Zach. Arnett. Like I said earlier, number 7 for Pudge Rodriguez. Let's go first base. Nope. We're gonna actually go with my actual secondary position. Catcher. Born in the automotive state. Motown. I didn't change any physical settings. Oh well.
Though encouraged by many to approach Scout Day just like any other workout, these players know it is in. After an anxious wait, a player is called to put his plate skills on display.
Okay.
Scout Day coaches do what they can to ground and focus the player for a stop-defining moment.
Damn it. Popping stuff up, like I said. That's all I do is pop stuff up.
Most of these prospects have played in games that were attended by a major league scout or two, but today there are 41 major league scouts in attendance.
I'm ready. Fuck. Oh, I thought I was ready. Nice way to start it off. Need to wait a little bit longer on it, though. Oh my God, I'm so early. Eighth of an inch.
fielding coach preps the player to showcase his defensive skills. This will be the last chance the player has to make an impression on this day.
Oh, that's hard. Okay.
In the big leagues, pristine defense is a must. The players know that an error-free showing would be the benchmark.
So, I want you guys, if you guys watch this after it gets uploaded, to tell me how you guys think I did. Where you guys think I'm going to go in the draft
some scouts come down
before
to make
you
contact with a player of interest. This is a marketplace, and though the
your potential was widely agreed upon already, but geez, you did validate that today. I'll keep you on. I'll probably go through the draft. If I don't like who I'm going to go to, I'll probably go to another.
A promising young baseball talent receives a call from his former high school coach, who has assumed an advisory role until the player sees fit to take on a sports agent. In the aftermath of a scout day, players are anxious to learn what impact their performance may have made. Modern media offers an unprecedented glut of feedback opportunities. But wisdom would suggest a young athlete focus on what is ahead, what is in his control.
We'll do these. Can finally edit my flight. Highway 182. Gotta make myself have a big butt, right? Big butt. Okay. Got. I actually really got the fuckboy haircut. But I'm gonna go with my normal. Not that. We'll go with the long curly. Yep, we're gonna go with long curly. You gotta get the thing, catfish hunter. No? Okay, we'll just do button chops. Gotta get the soul patch. Okay. Eye color blue. Wow, you can do a lot in this game. Okay. Equipment. Go with that. Go with white grip tape. Wow, you can do a lot in this game. I never realized this. Holy crap. Okay, I think we're about done. Cool. Five hundred training points. Okay. Do this.
Stepping up to the plate, Carlos Arias.
Capture it, Carlos Arias.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Now a bunt attempt here. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over.
Ooh.
So they pick up no. Stepping in, number nine, ready to get his day at the plate started right here. Hit the other way out toward right field.
Shit.
Fuentes will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. Ready for another chance? Carlos Arias comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. Hit hard down the line. Base hit, and they're into the hit column. Now a long throw to third, and he's safe. Stepping in and ready for another shot, number nine. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And he puts it up back behind second base. Perez takes charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out.
Next at bat, I'm not swinging on the first pitch.
Ready for another
Unless
shot
it's perfect.
Now. Number nine. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. Good swing. Just got to try and straighten that one out. One out with the possible tying and go-ahead runs on base here. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Whoa, right back at him, and it hit him. Thankfully, he's able to recover, and he gets the second out at first. Digging in to try it again, number nine. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that. Now a swing, and he pops him up, and this should do it. Lucas is there to make the catch, and with that, the ball game is over. A single run good enough to do it today. 1-0, the final score.
0 for 4.
The West win this one despite banging out only two hits. So that just about does it for Harold Reynolds. Dan, please.
You know what? I'm not going to bed until I get, hopefully, I have single A. Single A. Because if I get put in single A, I'm going to be pissed.
As the draft nears and teams begin to identify prospects they may target, a game of dreams also becomes a game of dollars. Information is currency. A team that gets a player to name a price may gain an early upper hand in negotiation. After all, why pay more if you can pay less? And why even place an order if you suspect it may never be delivered? To stand a chance in these talks, anticipation is a must. This is the game behind the game, and it needs to be played just as hard by those who want to come out on top.
Okay, let's try to get some more, you know, points. I'm playing like shit right now. It's okay. You know why it's okay? Because I'm trying. This is only my second day having, or technically
standing
my first
in,
day having this game.
Nino Lozano.
Designated hitter, Nino Lozano.
Now a bunt attempt here. Throw to the plate, and he will beat the tag, safe at the plate. In now, number nine. He'll take his first hacks here.
Number nine.
Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box.
Man, I tell you what, if I had a timeout and I went out there to talk to him, I'd say, look, we just got to minimize the damage. Bases loaded, no outs. We don't want them to blow the inning totally open.
A great job of changing speeds there. It's 0-2.
Boy, nothing more frustrating for the pitcher. You put the ball in play, and they kick it and get two errors behind you. Now you might think, I got to strike everybody out taking my own. That's when the game gets away from you. He's got to stay patient.
Standing in, Vincent McHugh. He'll start us out here in the home half of the second.
Vincent McHugh.
Down the third baseline. Throw to first is in time for the first out. Ready for another chance? Leo Chassin.
Number 19, Leo Chassin.
1-1, here it comes. Left side, scooped up. And the throw is wide as it pulls the first baseman off the bag. Digging in for his second at bat, number nine. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. On a less than impressive swing there to start the at bat. It's 0-1.
You can't help but feel good about yourself when you make a hitter look like that. That swing was heinous.
Soft liner to the left side. But gloved by the third baseman for the out. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think. Ready for another shot now, number nine. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one. Swing and a little blooper to center. Moreno comes on now and he has it, one down.
Fuck. I'm going in like the bottom of the draft.
Ready once again, number nine.
I cannot hit my way out of a wet paper bag.
He's struck out once. Swing and a miss out in front of a changeup.
Missed a pretty good pitch to hit right there. You know he wants that one back because you usually don't get more than one of those in an at bat.
No ball.
In the dirt here, the throw will go to third, and he is in there at third as the possible tying run. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. And he struck him out.
What the fuck, dude?
Wouldn't this be something if he could work out of this with that one run? Riding in once again, Everett Castro.
Catcher. Everett Castro.
Popped high in the air. And there's out number two. A one-run finish today, 5-4, the final score.
I'm playing like
shit.
So
that'll just about do it for us this afternoon.
Showcases and scouting activities having wrapped up, all attention turns to the imminent main event, the MLB draft. Lifelong dreams of being a pro ball player will be realized. Young dreamers will stand on edge to find out where will be the first stop on their road to the show.
Welcome back to the Major League Baseball First Year Player Draft. Rounds 1 through 5 are complete, so we will now begin the 6th round. The first selection of the 6th round is officially on the clock. With the 6th pick of the 6th round, the Oakland Athletics select the third baseman from the Central Region.
The awaited moment arrives. Many players will forever remember every detail of this conversation and moment. In the days and weeks that follow, teams work to come to terms with the players they have drafted and get them signed. In most cases, rookie contracts get done in a fairly straightforward manner. And with that, players and organizations alike are happy to have their team and get the season underway.
Division 2, or not Division 2, but Double A.
A Double A manager addresses his team before their season opener. For many of these young men, it is their first game as a professional.
So you know what? I'm not going to sleep until I get out of Division 2, or Double A. Unless I switch games. Because I do want to go to bed at night, that way I can get my Overwatch downloaded.
Minor League Baseball now on the show as our road trip makes a stop.
And I'm a little tired.
So striding in, number 8. This will be his first trip to the plate in this one.
Number 8.
They couldn't give me my number.
Well, he doubled up on that slider, so that tells me he's really feeling it at this point in the game. Good chance we'll see a heavy dose of that slider as this start continues.
Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2. Now a swing and a fly ball. Milano sprinting after it. But no chance to run it down. It's a foul ball. Up and in here as he had to bend out of danger.
Wow, fastball up and in. I'm not sure it was intended to be that far up and that far in, but message sent. Beware.
Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Milano is over to his left as he snags this one for the first. Striding in once again, number 8. He'll start things out in their half of the 6th as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've been completely overmatched to this point. One hit through 5.
Ready for another chance. Lamont Finley. No hits in 3 tries so far. Finley. He's struck out once. Now a bunt attempt here. And he'll be thrown out at first. So that didn't go quite according to plan. And with it, the inning. Ready once again. Terrell Jarvis. Catcher. No hits in 2 trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. And now a bunt attempt here as he gets this one down. And the throw to first will be in time, so they stamp out the bunt attempt. digging in to try it again.
All I gotta do is just hit the ball.
His line this far.
Number eight.
Line hard to center field.
Thank you.
And there's a base hit. So just like that, the leadoff man's aboard, representing the potential go-ahead run. And that right there was.
And a nice job here to come in and slam the door. That's his first save of the season, but it certainly won't be his last.
And this evening's contest comes to a close, 5-3, the final. Josh Smith claims the win out of the pen, his first. Ricky Sandoval records the save, his first of the year. So that just about does it.
Got a hit.
Welcome to MLB The Show and this presentation of Minor League Baseball.
Naturally, I should probably see if I can add any points.
Stepping into the box, number eight, ready to get his day at the plate started right here.
Number eight.
Pulled softly out toward right. And that'll land between everybody. Base hit. And the run will score from second as this ball game is tied one apiece.
Well, that's a nice hit. We're right back where we started with that RBI. Base hit. The game is tied.
Third baseman, Carlos Reyes.
Set to deal on 2-2. And he looks at a sinker for a called third strike. And now there are two gone. Now in the box, Dan Hoyt. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out. And of course, here in inning number two. And there he goes towards second. Line drive to left. In there, base hit, and that ought to get the run in from third.
Man, he turned on that fastball right there. Ripped the line drive and scored the run easy.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Tim McConnell. 0 for 1 here in the early going. Now the double steal is on here. And a big strikeout there. They'll leave a couple of runners on base, and after a good start to the inning, they can't. Banging in for his second at bat, number eight. He came through with an RBI single in his last at bat. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. So no runs, no hits.
Oh, yeah.
Ready for another shot now. Number eight, a hit in two tries so far. Swung on and missed for the first strike.
0-1.
Ready with the nothing and one pitch. And boy, this at bat is not starting off well as he's behind 0-2 now.
Oh man, he just tied him up in knots right there.
Nothing and two count. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. So nothing happening this time. Now at the plate, number eight. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat. Way out in front. Bases are empty, one man out. And boy, they're really
what the fuck am I even swinging at?
Now as he can't get extended there, and it's 0-2 now.
Man, he's got a good fastball. He showed it off right there. He blew it right by him.
Bell onto the grass. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. This one comes to a close with a 9-5 final. Terrell Rodriguez claims the win out of the pen, his first. So that's a wrap here tonight for my partners in the booth, Harold Reynolds and Dan Plezak. Welcome into this presentation of Minor League Baseball from the AA Texas League. Ready now, Damian Rose.
Designated hitter.
Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Grounded to third. In time to first, and there are two away. Stepping up to the plate, number eight. First trip to the plate for him in the ball game.
Third baseman, number eight.
Now a swing and a hard hit grounder, but a foul ball here, 0-1. The windup and the 0-1. Just a bit jumpy that time, swung on and missed. Here comes the nothing and two pitch. Here's a looping fly ball out to right. in there, a base hit.
Well, it's a big base hit, 0-2. Now, it started off soft, and then it came back with something hard. I don't know why he threw a hard fastball there, because he really pulled him on the off-speed stuff.
Dan Voigt.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Taken for strike three, the throw.
I am slower than dirt.
The money, and he's cut down trying to take second base.
Whew. Let me not do that again.
Striding into the box, number eight. A base hit in his
number
first trip.
Eight.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. And here's a ball hit in the air.
Try to wait on it a little bit too long.
After it, but no chance to run it down. It's a foul ball. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. And here's a swing and a miss as he falls behind nothing and two.
Obviously not where he wanted that curveball to end up, but I guess it fooled him enough to get the swing and miss.
Set to deliver on nothing and two. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning.
Well then, okay.
So no runs here on no hits. So coming to the plate, Jim Salas, and his guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, Matt, they've been really shut down so far in this one. They've had runners on base, but haven't been able to string anything together.
And the pitcher, in fact, will just take a bite out of this one, an infield single. Striding in, number eight, one for two on his line so far in the game. Here comes the first pitch. Swing and a miss just behind a lively fastball.
Well, with the leadoff man getting on right there, Matt, they are falling so far behind, they have to capitalize. They have to get some runs to get back in this thing.
Now a swing and a miss, and things are not looking real promising here, down 0-2.
I think a big reason why he's been so effective in this one, that he's been just about getting ahead of every hitter. Seems like every one of them are 0-2, 1-2, and it's just about every at-bat. And when that's the case, your chances of getting...
3-2, the finish in tonight's game. Enrique Bautista gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Matt Alvarez earns the save out of...
Dude, I suck. What's the number? Back of my head. Hopefully this game will be better than last year. If you guys have any tips, trust me, I could definitely use them in this.
Between the Springfield Cardinals and the Midland Rockhounds, it's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Striding in, number eight. He'll take his first tacks here.
Third baseman, number eight.
And that's inside for a ball, 1-0.
Can I just hit a bomb?
Count, here it is. This is line to left.
Nope, but I'll take it.
And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard. Digging in, Jimmy Comstock.
The shortstop. Jimmy Comstock.
The 0-2 home hits this one hard the other way, and that's through for a hit. Throw comes in quickly from left, so even on the hit and run, they'll hold thanks to first and second here.
Well, the hit and run,
dude, I'm slow.
Right there, and the runner running to second base on the steal. I thought he might go to third base. The ball ended up in the outfield. I guess he didn't feel comfortable. That's why he pulled up.
Lamb.
One and two, here it comes. Pitch misses low. The throw down. Digging in for his second at bat, number eight. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. Driven down the left field line, will it stay fair? It will, just to the right of the chalk, a fair ball. The relay, and he's going to make it. He's in at second base with a leadoff double. Digging in to try it again, Jimmy Comstock.
Shortstop, Jimmy Comstock.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch. Got him. The slurve that time, and that'll be the first out of the inning. Trying to pick things up where we left off. Owen Lamb.
Number three, Owen Lamb.
Swing and a miss. Got him with the slurve there. Two gone. Striding in once again, B.J. Saunders.
Catcher, B.J. Saunders.
Getting a few steps off a second there. Now the pitch. This one's down to third. Throw in time and the side is retired. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors and a man left. Ready once again, number eight. He doubled earlier and carries a 2-for-2 line into this appearance. Swing and a miss that time. It's 0-1. Now the 0-1. Line towards center field.
Will it drop? Oh, yeah.
And that's into the outfield for a one-out.
I know that my, you know, battery's dying and I'm playing on beginner. But
tonight he's setting the trend for the rest of this series. I'm curious how they're going to pitch him the rest of the way out.
Ready for another chance? Jimmy Comstock. One for two on his line so far in the game. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And that pitch is lined into left field, and he's got his second hit of the evening. Throw into third.
Oh, I could have made it, too.
Clearly, that was a hit and run. The runner was off on the swing, and he drives the ball so hard to the outfield, they couldn't advance him.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Owen Lamb comes in one for two with that home run he hit earlier. Oh, it's hit to third. Five, four, three, but it's not in time, and the inning will continue. A tag, and he's out trying to tag up there. It's a double play. Digging in once again, number eight. He's got three hits, and
pushing
a double to this point. Oh, had him chopping at that one. It's nothing and one.
Well, he swung right through that on that changeup. The changeup is a tough pitch to swing at for the first pitch. You haven't measured his velocity yet. You don't know what you're going to see coming your direction.
And that gets through for a one-out base hit.
Here, he pulls a changeup that's away. You're supposed to hit the other way and gets the base hit. Other times, he takes that ball the other way, hits a line drive, and doesn't get the hit.
Now batting.
Digging in and looking for more, Jimmy Comstock.
Comstock.
Looking for hit number three here in this at-bat. Taken for strike three, the throw. And he can't hold on to the throw as it short hops him and eats him up.
I like the aggressiveness with two strikes to put the runner in motion. Sometimes that can backfire and it can turn into one of those strike him out, throw him out double plays, but he was able to get there safely at second.
Ready for another shot now, Owen Lamb.
Number three, Owen Lamb.
Good lead there at second. Here's the pitch. Line to the right side, but a little unlucky there as it's hit right to him in right field for the final out of the inning.
It's okay.
4-2, the final score tonight. Four for four. Weiler gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Charles Brassard earns the save out of the bullpen, his first of the year. So that just about does it for Harold Reynolds, Dan Plesac, and our crew. I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way on over to theshownation.com.
15 runners left.
left on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 49 minutes. Thanks for joining us this evening, and please drive home safely.
Okay. Go to the next game.
Welcome to MLB The Show and this presentation of Minor League Baseball. In now, number eight, and we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home so far this inning. And here's a ball hit in the air. Saul moving forward. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score. Digging in the switch hitter, Owen Lamb.
Left fielder, Owen Lamb.
A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. Now in the box, number eight, looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at bat. And that misses for ball one.
Will, like, taking balls, like, help you in the long run? Like, with your overall stats and stuff?
Swing and a little blooper to center. Oh, and he misses it! Thought about going for second, but instead...
That was so dumb.
Got him in a pickle, and they will tag him out between...
Whatever.
Now at the plate, number eight. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Squared that one up just a little late. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. And boy, was he ever fooled on that pitch. It's 0-2 now.
Not much to say about that swing other than
that's
it should have never happened.
The 0-2 home. And that's lifted in the air out toward left. Lott is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. And he will scurry back. Coming to the plate now, Robbie Chacon. He represents the potential tying run if he can launch one or find a way around the bases.
Yeah, Matt, I kind of doubt he's thinking about going yard, even though that would be the best result they could hope for. He's not a long ball threat, and he knows it. So he could just be looking for some way to keep that line moving.
Tonight's ball game comes to a close, 3-1 the final. Andrew Triggs earns his first win of the season. Ricky Sandoval wraps it up for the save, his second. So that'll just about do it.
Okay, you know what? I think I've had enough of this for tonight. I know I said that I wouldn't go to bed until I hit AAA, but that's a long ways away from right now. I think I'm just going to do a little bit more of my Diamond Dynasty. Oh, excuse me, of my Diamond Dynasty. I don't know how to save and quit. Fuck it. Oh well. Let's see. Okay, I know Darren O'Day is a almost sidearm or almost submarine pitcher. had to get a lefty in there. Sure. Why he's not in my lineup, I do not know. I'll take Jonathan the scoop. Okay, I really can't get rid of Todd Frazier. Troy Tulowitzki, my man. Not about to lie, one of my favorite players. I liked him more when he played for, what team was it? Colorado. But it's A-OK. Anthony Gose. Why do I not have Curtis in? Who's my right fielder? Eddie Rosario. Not anymore. Never gonna leave you. I love to pick Michael Fulmer, but knowing me, I'm not going to get Michael Fulmer. Bud Norris.
From the land of 10,000 lakes, we've got afternoon baseball from Target Field in Minneapolis. It should be a good conquest matchup tonight between the 51s and the Twins. Fan allegiances in a key territory are on the line.
Who already? Now a swing and a ball hit high and deep. I think I'm learning how to hit.
Standing in now, Denard Span.
Denard
Span.
Nope. Swing and pop it in the air right near home plate. Castro is camped under this one, and he puts it away for the first down.
Batting third.
Here's Troy Tulowitzki now. One run in and one gone so far this inning. And a half.
What am I swinging
swing
at?
There as he tried to go the other way, and it's strike one.
Matt, this could be a real special end. They've already hit a home run here, and now the real power is starting to come to the plate. We might be in for a light show.
This is hit high in the air toward left center.
Not quite.
Buxton calls off the left fielder as he takes charge for the second out.
Batting fourth.
It is Curtis Granderson.
Curtis Granderson.
And he's squaring around here, but he can't connect one strike. Now here it comes. bunt attempt.
Oh, and I'm gonna.
And he'll be thrown out at first. So that didn't go quite according to plan, and with it, the inning is.
Whatever.
Stepping up now, Eddie.
You guys
Rosario
know what I tried to do.
Things off here in the
oh, I didn't even save the changes.
Left fielder, zero.
Swing and a miss. Just behind a lively fastball. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate.
Ooh, that's one he wants back right now. Man, it looked like his timing was perfect. He just didn't barrel it up.
And he missed with it. It's one and two.
Pretty good pitch and a great take there. There's not a lot you can do with that slider breaking down unless you can catch it way out front and hook it down the line. You see a lot of swinging misses on those.
So he gets the swinging strikeout on the changeup. Eddie Rosario is retired for the first out here in the bottom half of the first. Byron Buxton.
The first time I ever threw a cutter, he's still one of my better friends, and he kind of hit it out. That's why if you guys watch me, I probably won't throw it a lot. Ooh.
Here we go. Did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around at strike three. Stepping up to the plate, Kenny's Vargas. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. The 1-0 delivery. And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss.
Boy, he juked him out of his shoes with that changeup. Stood almost.
I know this is risky, but it's okay.
But it probably looked good coming in.
One and two now. Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes.
Ooh.
Struck him out, so he makes quick work of him here.
This is what I need to do now.
Second baseman, Jonathan Scope.
Swing and a miss that time. It's 0-1. Wind up and the 0-1. Hot shot to third and handled for the first out. Here's Marwin Gonzalez now.
Marwin Gonzalez
sends that one out of play for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Slider taken here. One ball, one strike. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Pitch popped up. Castro has a play, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
Batting seventh.
So bases are empty here with two
gone.
And standing in a power threat in Todd Frazier, the third baseman. Lifted into center field.
Up one.
Under it, Buxton.
Peanuts crack. Third
and the inning is over. So they're held in check here this half of the inning.
Yep.
Here's Miguel Sano. He'll get us leading going here in the bottom half of the second.
Third baseman, Miguel.
Foul back.
I miss playing FIFA.
A high fastball is in there.
We're seeing quite a few pitches
I'm gonna wait,
from him
okay,
right now,
to buy the new
obviously
one.
Be dangerous. A cold strike there, but he might
buy it. I might buy it next week.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2.
No, I'm gonna buy that new game Friday the 13th. Well, I don't really know if it's new, but Friday the 13th.
And I'm looking down at third base at the Todd Father. Todd Frazier, yeah, the Little League superstar from the 98 World Series when he was the MVP and led his team from Toms River. He's matured now to a Major League All-Star third baseman. Really impressive resume.
Recovery play to get the second out, but we'll have to make sure he's okay on the mound.
Brian Dozier.
Brian Dozier trying to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Up and in for ball one. And he watches one split the middle here, 1-1. Norris into the windup, coming home with the 1-1 pitch. Changeup just off the black, and it's 2-1. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. And he'll stay alive here, but just barely as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count holds at 2-2. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Again, he sends it out of play. Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit hard back up the middle. That gets down, and the inning will continue. He's through first and hustling for second. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double.
Great execution. You hit it where it's thrown, right? That ball's thrown right up the middle.
Holy crap, right, I just turned around and there's sunshine outside.
Eduardo Escobar.
Eduardo Escobar standing in. Grounded up the first baseline. Gonzalez is there. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning.
Kind of scared me for a second.
Welcome back to Minneapolis, Minnesota. Time now for the third inning to get underway from Target Field.
Catcher.
First pitch coming. Here it is. And he's in front of a tight little slider that time.
That just can't happen. I mean, first pitch, if you know what you're going to swing at, you got to have a good swing. You can't take a bad swing on the first pitch of an at-bat.
There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Gone!
Ooh.
To lead off the inning.
Well, in just I really like those leadoff home runs, apparently.
He's given up two homers. Could be just one of those games for him. We'll see how much rope they give him. It's definitely getting shorter at the moment.
Anthony goes. We'll grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 12, Anthony goes.
And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
Matt, I'm telling you, pitchers are stubborn, right? He gives up a home run on that very same pitch, but he came back with it. This time he got it down. He's stubborn. I'm going to come back. I'm going to throw it again, but I'm going to execute it. And he did.
That sucks.
Rosario. Has to retreat a bit, but he gets there for out number one.
Center fielder.
Trying to pick things up where he left off. Starling Marte. He got a hold of one and went yard in his first appearance in this one. Vargas is there for it. And that's the second out of the inning.
Left fielder number two.
Coming to the plate Denard now. Denard Span. 0-1 for him here in this one. And here's a ball hit in the air. Oh, and he misses it.
That's pretty cool.
Digging in to try it again. Troy Tulowitzki. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-1 so far. First pitch on its way. Hot shot down the line. And a good effort on the dive that time, but this will get by him for a base hit.
No? Okay.
Well, third baseman did everything he could on that ball. That ball was just scorched right past him. Laid out, got dirty. I thought for a second he was going to have it. Just couldn't come up with it.
Stepping in now, Curtis Granderson. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Hit weakly back to the mound. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. So one run on two hits, including the home run, one error, and two men left on base. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. The 51s are out on top, 2-0. Josh Edgen, a 6'1" southpaw, will be the one that gets the call from the bullpen here. Jason Castro is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one.
There's going to be a lot of me not talking in this.
When you've got a guy that throws a good two-seam fastball,
I'm sorry,
you have
guys.
To be ready for him to try to run
I'm probably
going to
look at this later.
Good job to lay off that one, but I wouldn't be surprised if we see it again.
Turned on that one and crushed it. Just
trying to focus.
Swing and
there
a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away. Robbie Grossman will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone.
I might actually go back to Minecraft after
he'll
this game.
Power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one.
You guys think that you guys would like to see Minecraft on this too?
Down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now. 0-2. Swing and a liner. Throw in time at first for out number two.
The stream will probably end after this game, since nobody's watching anyways at this point. But just gotta make myself known. Gotta put in the grinding time.
That's not all that consistent, but it's strike one.
He has been aggressive in this inning. 0-2 on this hitter. The first two outs were recorded quick because he came right after the hitter. I don't think that changes right now either.
And he gets strike three called to end it here. And with that, this one is over. A 2-0 finish today. Kyle Gibson worked only three innings in the losing effort.
Okay, everybody. Oh, wait, hold on. Damn. Of course, they're going to give me the stadium. Everybody have fun. And I'll see you next time.